about people? Long time no car vlog. I'm trying to be incognito because, okay. Anyways, I was gonna go to Starbucks and work on my final written assignment for my school, but there's no places to sit, and I already ordered my stupid drink, and I should have gotten a seat first and then ordered my drink, but I was just like, I don't know, I just didn't. And then, so by the time I finished ordering my drink, there was no seats. And so I was like standing waiting for my drink, and then there was this guy that was sitting kind of close to where I was standing, and he asked me, because he was sitting down, but he had his stuff on a chair next to him. He's like, are you waiting for a place to sit down? And I was like, like, what do I say? I don't want to sit next to this guy, because where he was sitting, it was like four chairs. It was like, you know, like a bar stool kind of thing. It was like the counter, and then there's like the four stools or whatever. And there was three people sitting there already. And I was like, I don't want to be all squished with, and they were all guys too. I was like, I don't want to be squished with all these guys. And then I was just like, because I was kind of waiting for a place to sit, but I was waiting for my drink, and I was just honestly already thinking, I'm just going to get my drink, and I'm just going to go in my car and film a fucked up YouTube video, because I haven't been keeping up with that, and I'll just work on my essay tomorrow at home or something. And then, so it's just like, I looked at him for a long time, and I didn't say anything. I was like, and he made a face like hello or something like that, and I was like, yeah. I was like, oh well, you can sit next to me. And I was like, okay, thank you. And I started to put my stuff in that spot, and then I turned on my laptop, and my laptop was out of battery, and there was no outlets near, so I was like, cool. And I just packed up my stuff and I just went in my car. But yeah, cool story, bro. But anyways, yeah. So, also, before I went to Starbucks, I went by this, I found a new grocery, a new health food store. And it's kind of like a restaurant and kind of like a grocery store. It's kind of like a takeout restaurant, but like healthy. They sell like salads and stuff. I ordered from there one time when I was at, it was like during our exam time for ballet exams, like a few years ago, at my work. And then is when we do ballet exams, it's like an all-day thing, so we always would order lunch from like local businesses. And so we ordered some salads from there, and they were pretty good from what I remember. But I just checked it out a few weeks ago, because I was like, because I was coming to Starbucks a few weeks ago too to work on my essay, and I wanted something chocolatey to go with my little fucked up coffee. And so, but I didn't want to get like a real chocolatey thing, because a real chocolatey thing has sugar in it, and everyone already knows I don't want to be eating that. So I was like, what kind of place near there sells like healthier, you know, desserts? And I was like, oh yeah, that place that we got salads from, yeah, that was like a grocery store too. Maybe they have some stuff. So I went, and they have so much cool stuff there. They have so much cool stuff. It's like a little health food store, you know, like the ones that I've been finding out about in my area. You know, they sell brands that they sell at Sprouts and Whole Foods, and it's really cool. It's just like a little fucked up little health food store. And last time I went there, the guy that was checking out my groceries, he said that they were building two more locations in the next year, like kind of nearby. So I was like, cool. And he's like, yeah, and they're gonna be bigger locations. And I was like, wow, that's so cool. That's so freaking cool. But so yeah, health food stores are coming up. So anyway, so I went there today because I wanted to get my little chocolate thing so I could eat with my little coffee when I worked on my homework. But I can't work on my homework right now, so I'll just show you guys what I got. I just got a few things. Partly because after this I'm going to teach for like 5 hours and then I'm going to go work out for like an hour. So I'm not going to get home until like 10 o'clock tonight. Right now it's like almost 2:30. So I wasn't going to get any like refrigerated stuff because it's just going to go bad. But I got a few little snacks and I just made a mental note. I'm like, okay, Michelle, you need to come back here when you're planning on buying more groceries and you can like go home right away, you know, put the stuff away. But they had a lot of cool stuff. But anyways, let me just show you what I got today. Oh yeah, and what I got at Starbucks, this is just like, if I don't remember to bring my Puro, my little instant, coffee alternative that has no caffeine because it's just made out of grains, I just get a soy milk decaf latte because no dairy and I don't really want to be drinking coffee, even though decaf still has a little bit of caffeine. It's still less caffeine. And I get a tall because it's like less, I don't need to be drinking that much. And if you get iced, it's pros and cons if you get an iced one. If you get an iced one, that means there's less drink in there. And I know for most people, and for me in the past, it's been like, the ice takes up so much space. You don't get as much to drink. But honestly, you really shouldn't be drinking that stuff anyway. So it's like, not really a bad thing. It's actually a good thing that the ice takes up a lot of space. You don't drink as much of that, you know, stuff. But anyways, but if I get a warm one, I still get a tall, but I ask them to do child's temperature, so it's not too hot. But anyways, so my little chocolatey thing that you guys have seen before that I always love to get is the Hail Mary chocolate tart. This is the almond butter flavor. It's great. It has no sugar in it. And it's really chocolatey, so I really like it. It's great. This is like the best dessert that I have found at the grocery stores for people who are macrobiotic, you know, transitioning. Because real macrobiotic people don't eat chocolate at all. So I'm still transitioning. Okay. They say the first 3 years, like 3 to 5 years, is like you're transitioning still. So, yeah, if you can make it that long, because most people, it's all over their thing, most people by like the 5 year mark is kind of like when they decide, I'm going to do this for the rest of my life, or they're going to be like, this is too hard, I can't deal with it, and they go back to their regular way, or they, you know, kind of go to just like vegan or vegetarian eating, so. But I hope that I can stick with it. But anyways, so right now it's like I've been macrobiotic, you know, in transition for a year and like 3 months. It's almost a year and a half. So far it's great. Wow. It's a struggle, but it's worth it. Cool. Okay, so I got that, and I got 3 different kinds of vegan jerky. So I tried this, and they're all from the same brand, Louisville vegan jerky. And I tried the peppered flavor, and I really, really liked the peppered flavor. I picked up 3 different flavors today. They have some other ones, but the other ones have sugar in them, and again, that's not something I want to be eating. You know, it's part of, you know, macrobiotics, like avoid extreme, and extreme yin is sugar, so But anyways, so I got this sriracha maple flavor. And then I got this. This one is in different packaging because it's a limited edition one. But this is the buffalo dill one. And then the last thing that I got and the last flavor is the smoked chipotle one. So yeah, I'm excited to try it. They're non-GMO soy, because what the jerky is like soy protein. So and the thing about soy that you have to, you know, be mindful of is not to get is to try to get non-GMO or organic soy products, you know. So that's what I got. So the only thing, they are the peppered flavor that I tried before, it was really, really good. Like each time that I ate them, like I ate them all in one sitting, like the whole package. The only thing is that they are very salty, which goes with like any kind of jerky thing. It's like very salty. But yeah, that's what I was gonna say. It's just that it is very salty. So I don't always get these things, but they're really good, and they're a good little you know, vegan snack, you know, because not every little you know, little junk food, little snack food that's vegan is actually the best thing to be eating. And that's part of why I, you know, don't really, that's part of why I'm not a vegan, because it's like so many of their foods is not really, and the thing is, and it's different because if people are coming from a very extreme lifestyle, you know, of eating, you know, veganism is a great place to be at, you know, if you're coming from a place that's very extreme. It's like a lot better than the standard American diet. So in that way, you know, it's great if people who are wanting to eat healthier, they check out veganism, and they have a whole bunch of, you know, vegan junk foods. It's just like plant-based versions of regular American food, which is already, even though it's not the best thing you could be eating, is already a huge improvement than what they were eating. You feel me? So in that way, it's like great. And for, you know, macrobiotic people that are transitioning, you know, this, of course, you gotta pick and choose, because a lot of you know, vegan little snacks and stuff do have sugar, and that's something that vegans don't really care about too much. You know, it's not really a problem for them. So so if you're, you know, macrobiotic and you're transitioning, you have to, like, you know, really look at the ingredients, you know, and all that stuff. But, you know, I'm appreciative that it's available to me, you know, little healthier versions of my favorite old, you know, junk food. But at the same time, you know, it's not the best thing to be eating. It's not, some, these little beef jerky things are not something I want to be eating, you know, 5 years from now. You know, this is like a good, like, transition, you know. So I'm really trying to, when I talk about things that I don't really agree with, I'm really trying not to say things in a fucked up way, you know. I'm really trying. So, you know, when people talk to me that are, you know, vegan or vegetarian, or, you know, kind of interested in more plant-based eating, and they talk to me, and they don't know a lot about macrobiotics, but just because they see my posts and they talk to me for a little bit, they kind of know, you know, when you eat macrobiotic, you still eat a little bit of animal food. And they talk to me like veganism is the ultimate thing. They talk to me like, oh, are you full vegan yet? And it's like, like, they're talking to me like full vegan is like the ultimate thing. It's like, it's not, because it's not, because it's not about, they just think, people just generally think about I want to say like all or nothing, and they think, you know, especially vegans and the typical, image of a vegan is so almost militaristic about animal products, like no animal product ever. So when they know that I eat sometimes a little bit of animal product, and they talk to me like it's macrobiotics is a halfway point. It's not the halfway point. Macrobiotics is the ultimate point. Veganism is like the halfway point. You feel me? But it's because people don't really know, and they only think about it. They only think about it in terms of what are you eating? It's like, oh, you still eat animal products, so that's like halfway. No, it's not. You know? I don't know if I'm making sense. But it's not really about what you eat. Just like it's not really about you what you do, it's the way that you do it. It's not really about what you eat. It's like, you know, what is the purpose of what you eat? You feel me? It's like, because this is me. When I was a vegan a long time ago, when I was like 14, 15 years old, I was vegan. And it was for fucked up reasons, okay? It was only because it was a new trendy diet, and all what I was motivated by was, oh, I'm gonna lose weight, oh, I'm gonna lose weight. So the way that I was vegan was I was just looking at stuff that said vegan on it. I didn't even like really eat like, I didn't even eat balanced. It's just like Trisha Paytas when she goes on her, when she's a vegan for like 2 weeks and all she eats is like fruit. And it's like, okay, so you feel me? Like, it doesn't make sense. It's like, it's not really about what you eat. It's not like, it's what's behind it. Why are you eating that way? You feel me? And this is the thing, you know, a major point why I don't, you know, that I don't agree with veganism, and it's so different from macrobiotics, is like, when you choose to become a vegan, what are the reasons people choose to do that? You know, save the animals, you know, save the planet, be healthier, lose weight. Four things, right? Four. Okay, and when you choose to become a vegan, there's not really any kind of, I mean, beyond those four major things, there's not really anything more than that. It's just those four things. And those are great things. Those are very important things, but it's like, there's no like there's no guidelines of thinking beyond that. I mean, you can totally, and I talked to some of my vegan friends, and you know, I just let them talk to me, you know, whatever, because they're whatever they're into, you know, I just let them talk, because you know, a lot of people today, they think veganism is a shit, and from what they're coming from, it is the shit for them. You feel me? But I'm just like, I just keep my mouth shut, because I don't want to sound like an asshole, which I already do, and I just let them talk to me, and, you know, they come to similar things, you know, through veganism that is, like, standard in macrobiotics, is, like, common knowledge in macrobiotics, and for vegans to come to that is kind of, like, they think it's, like, a huge revelation, like, it's a huge thing, and yes, it is. But the thing is, in macrobiotics, that's like ABCs, you feel me? So that's why, I really want, you know, people out there to know that there's more than that. I mean, it's a great stepping place. But it's not the shit. I mean, it might be the shit for you, but it's really not. There's more out there. And I think it's, I honestly think it's because it's like a trend right now. And it's a cool trend to have. Better have a trend of being vegan than have a trend of, you know, being a carnivore. Like, you know, it's kind of like, well, that's a better trend, you know, but it's still not complete. But it's gonna take like 1,000 years, 1,000 to 2,000 years, for everyone to come to, you know, this understanding. But I don't know what I'm saying, but there's this guy in front of me, he's really weird, in front of my car. But yeah, I'll link down below. I've linked in other videos. Oh, because what I was saying, I think I already made my point clear. But what I was saying when I was talking about when I was vegan and I was just looking for food that was like, that said vegan or whatever. Because, I mean, a lot of, and you guys already know this, if you're meat eaters, if you're, you know, whatever you are, people already know this. A lot of people, you know, who are vegan, they don't really do it balanced, like how I was saying, how I was. So they just see stuff that says vegan, they just buy it. They don't really eat, like, how many vegans actually eat vegetables every day? You know, like, Lucky Charms are vegan, okay? Oreos are vegan. So it's like, people can do, even though they're vegan, they say they're vegan, they do it in a fucked up way, and it's still not, you know? But then even people who are macrobiotic say they're macrobiotic, but they still, you know, do fucked up shit too. So it could go either way, but, you know, I'm just pointing out, just because you know, it's different. If you're gonna, it's not what you do, it's the way that you do it. It's exactly what I said before. It's like, you know, because you can also be vegan and eat like whole grains and eat, you know, whole food. You don't just have to be eating, you know, all this vegan junk food, but it's just because it's like the trend, you know. I don't know what I'm saying. I don't know what I'm saying, but yeah. How did I even get on that? Well, because I was showing food, but anyways, I don't know what else to say. I guess that's it. Oh, because what I started to say too, I will link down below some lectures of Michio Kushi. He was, I mean, I talked about him before. You know, he was a really influential guy, you know, in the health food revolution, and he's he was considered, you know, the father of macrobiotics, modern macrobiotics. And I mean, I've only seen two of his lectures, and I know some of my friends knew him, and, you know, they tell me, you know, stories about him, and, you know, things he would say, and I've read, you know, a few books from him, and, you know, you just need to watch one of his lectures. Just watch, like, a few minutes of one of his lectures, and you will see, you know, the difference that I'm talking about. You know, between veganism and macrobiotics. It's like, it's not real. All his lectures that I have seen, they're like hour-long lectures, and he only talks about food for the last 5 minutes. It's all about way more than just what you eat. You know, it's all the stuff behind it, like, you know, the way that you think and how you view things and how you know, and it's just all that. You know, and you can apply it to every part of your life. It's not just about food. It's not just to lose weight. It's just not to save the animals. It's not just to save the planet. You know, it's not just to be healthy. It's for literally every single thing in the whole entire universe. And you just apply it to your food. Isn't that a better, I think that's a way better way to think about, you know, to think about your food, not just, you know, for a few reasons. It's like for everything in the whole universe. Because, and that's another thing, you know, because Western culture, Western society, Western way of thinking, which is, you know, dominant in our world today, is not always the best way. And just because it's the only way that everyone, that most people know, doesn't mean it's the only way and it's the right way and it's the best way. And you know, part of, you know, the Western way of thinking is good and bad, is black and white, is like so dualistic. There's like no in between and everything is separated. That's why in Western medicine, they still haven't gotten it together that the mind and the body are one, that they're connected. They still treat mental illness and physical illness as two separate things. You know, if you have seen someone for your mental illness, when have they ever talked to you about what you're eating? When? Has any psychiatrist, has any therapist, anyone ever talked to you about what you're eating is contributing to your mental health? Raise your hand. Whose therapist has ever talked to them about what they're eating? Because they still don't, they think it has nothing to do with it. You know? And it's like, okay. Well, it's not separate. They, you know, Western thinking thinks of everything as separate and nothing is connected, or only a few things are connected. And if you talk to, you know, someone who really believes in that stuff, like, you know, they think, and you say like, oh, well, everything's connected, you know, they think that you're crazy, like you're a hippie or like something, like you're like, but really, no. That's not. So that's, you know, that's the problem with veganism, I think, is they think, you know, it's only connected in those four areas, you know. You know, health, losing weight, saving the planet, saving the animals. Like, that's it. That's the extent of what their eating impacts, you know. But it's like, girl, it affects the whole world. It affects how you behave. It affects what you attract in your life. It affects literally everything. So I'm just saying, there's a more complete way out there. There's a more complete way out there. And if you don't think it's true, do your own research, okay? Do your own research. Don't listen to what I say. Do your own research. And you will find out. The truth is out there. And it has been out there for over 100 years. And, you know, only recently, some, you know, medical doctors, research has come out, just the tip of the iceberg. Whatever they're saying, you know, whatever your doctor is saying now, whatever, you know, vegans are saying now, it's just the tip of the iceberg of macrobiotics. They have already come to that over 100 years ago. So I'm just saying, look it up, do your own research, you will see. But anyways, thanks for watching this video. See you guys in the next one. Later, haters. Think differently.